everyone, this is going to be my first YouTube video. Hopefully this all works out all right. What you're seeing here is a John Deere 450 crawler loader. I'm having issues with it. It loads down and will not move, and I'm going to kind of show this in the video and some of the steps I've done to try to figure out what's wrong with this machine, why it won't move when I get the bucket in the dirt, or why it won't move when I go up an incline or something like that. So anytime there's some pressure against it, it doesn't want to move forward. Reverse, got a little bit more power. Got this machine about a year ago, and I worked pushing dirt and things for about a year then, in high low range. It's the only way that it would move and have some power. Low range would bog down and would not function at all. So I'm gonna do a quick walk around. I gotta jump it, so got the cables ready to hook it up. Down below here I've got a petcock from a fuel line to the tank, so I'm gonna go ahead and get that turned on so I can get it started. Top of the transmission here, I've got a pressure gauge that got mounted to see the pressure in the transmission. What I've noticed is I got good 150 pounds of pressure when it's moving, but as soon as I get that loaded version, then I go down to zero and I practically get a suction down here in this little bunghole. There is some fluid that comes up out of there, some hydraulic oil for the transmission. Bubbles out at about 150 pounds when this thing is full gauge. And then when it goes zero, it's kind of a suction. It sucks it all back down into the hole. So I was told that's a vent, that's normal. That bung hole was in there and the pipe plug was reinstalled, that you wouldn't get that leakage coming out of there, but the cap would cover that. And then over here, just above here, I've got a cap plug. There's a spring in there, and that's a pressure loader valve for your transmission power, and that's where you can regulate pressure on your gauges for that 150 pounds pressure that you get when things are moving and working good. Another thing that they described, this is what I find out in the jdcrawlers.com message board, that you should have some pressure drop on this cooler right here. The left side of this radiator is a cooler. The transmission, and it goes through that oil filter there. So I've got those gauges installed, and there should be a pressure drop, and I do have that pressure drop. It's about 120 pounds on the upper high side. It's down to about 70 pounds on the low side, and before it goes back into the transmission. Got a pretty good leak on my fuel pump. It's a diesel, and I'll show you that drip when I get it fired up. But yeah, this is John Deere 450. It's about a 1960 model. We're going to get it started up, and I'm going to start showing those pressures here. bear with me while I fire the fit up.